risky, yes, you're very risky.
Risky.
What yo?
Roach Beats.
Big ways, fine face, 10 days. I don't dare wait for you, my charge. For you, my charge. You want the phone?
Yes.
No case. I no go talk. Scar face for you, my charge. For you, my charge.
Take me everywhere you want to go.
Tell me everything I want to know. No lie. No lie. Yeah. Run am anyhow you want to run. Shake up, baby girl, you fire fast, you gone. No doubt. No doubt. But you say, kilo come, I'm getting money. Biggie money, so what's the fun? Ubi risky, body whiskey. Get tipsy, but all the bar risky. Kilo come, I'm getting money. Biggie money.
Something like, okay, I want us to, you know, talk about like this issue of foreign born.
Yeah.
Like, don't you think we have to do something with the grassroots? With the way we are going, there's nothing wrong with using diaspora. They are Nigerians. Any Nigerians have the right to play for our national team. But what happened to our football back home? Don't you see that it's dying and there are still talent there and we are not developing on anything?
Yeah, of course, that's a fact. The base of every country's football is grassroots. Unfortunately for Nigeria, we have abandoned the grassroots over the years. Many years ago, youth fund used to be the conduit pipe for the production of talent in Nigeria. Most of our ex-internationals went through youth fund. But today, if you ask anyone where is youth fund, it's dead and buried. Our school sports is dead. We all went to school in Nigeria. We passed through principal's corp. And all of these school tournaments, a lot of football talents were discovered through all of this tournament. But as we speak now, it is no more in existence. And that in itself is a tragedy. This has affected the proper development of Nigerian football. I agree with you. I mean, it's not a bad thing in getting the best hands from abroad.
But looking at the future times, because at times there, if you notice, there is even a law. England is trying to pass a law through FIFA. England is even trying now through FIFA to make a law so that we can't just train a child with our facilities and when it's ripe to and you just put it.
Yeah.
So let's say in future they stop this. Well,
I mean good vision. I mean good point you have made. Every country must look inward. First thing first, you must look at how to develop sports within your country, because that way you can have a chain of players growing through a process. Because for example, Germany invested over 10 million euros every year to develop what they have today. And that team, a project they started many years ago, morphed into a World Cup winning team. That's what grassroots development can do. Mm-hmm. And it costs a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in Germany, there's a serious scouting program that is set up where players are scouted nationally, you know, in different regions. It costs a lot of money to do, but it's an investment that yields dividends in future.
Exactly.
So every country, like you said, must begin to look inwards, must begin to think of how to develop from the base. However, you can marry the two. You can get players from abroad. You can get the best talent from within. Because if you focus on only getting players from abroad, like you said, you are going to leave local football to die. And in the long run, the country will suffer.
Yeah, my brother, what's your opinion? What do you think?
For me, on the issue of home base and foreign base,
maybe we shouldn't say like that.
Yeah,
like
home base against foreign base
players generally.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you know, we are talking of the foundation.
Yeah,
we are not investing. We don't even have league.
Of course, right now.
The future, how will I put, implications?
Yeah.
Of relying solely on, you know,
on European
groomed.
Yeah, I think it's a good future because you will agree with me that the system there is working. Like, I remember the first time I met Mr. Simon. I'm quoting him on this. He said to me, the training facilities in France is even more bigger than what they have in Levante. And this is a big player that has opened, you know, he represented us in the just concluded Nations Cup. And so now imagine where you have players of 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 growing up in Europe, you know, going through a structure, a system that works. They don't have the not lying about their age, you know, which tells when they age, you can tell when somebody said it's 22 or they're already 35, 37, you could tell they were not their best. But the kids that are born in Europe here, they have, if you say she's 5, Kamadu Kakoye, for example, you can tell he's 19. So they haven't gone through that system like that, a system like that that works, a facility that works. Training, you know, first class training. These kids, I'm fortunate to see some of them in secondary schools. You know, you see the facilities they have for trainings. This training, the ones they have are the ones even our clubs we don't have at home in Nigeria.
But what's stopping us from putting that down? Which country? Morocco? Just Casablanca?
Yes, Raja Casablanca.
They just have the massive plan. You need to see the plan on ground for their academy. Right now, they are starting to build it.
I mean, apart from that, these guys...
What's stopping us from having foundation? Is it the fund or vision?
It's a combination of both, but more of vision, because they say when there's a will, there will be a way. There's a serious lack of vision. Nigerian football itself does not have a blueprint. The major responsibility of every football association is football development. Unfortunately, that isn't the focus of the Nigerian Football Federation. Nigerian Football Federation is only focused on the Super Eagles. And that is the top.
I'm just about to say that.
Yeah.
We right now, we only rely on.
We have only super. And unfortunately, you need to have a foundation that will feed the super egos. But we don't have the foundation. And that is why, obviously, we are relying so much on players trained, and refined, developed abroad. It's not a bad idea. It's what you call a stopgap measure.
Exactly.
It's a quick fix measure. It's an idea that, it's a way of cutting corners. Like we say in pidgin parlance, wuru wuru to the answer. Unfortunately, we cannot find the answer. You get? So, it's patchy. We must go back to, unfortunately, a drawing board the drawing board is tired. But we must still go back to it and plead with it that allow us to come back to you. So that we can refine and find a new direction.
Mm-hmm.
We need to basically do a reset. Start from the scratch. And develop a blueprint and start to work with that blueprint. Learn from countries like Germany. I always use Germany as an example. Not only in football, in almost everything. It's a country that is known for efficiency. And that efficiency is what they apply to almost everything they do. So we need to have this kind of vision. Unfortunately, the people running football today in Nigeria are people who are just hungry for praise. So because they are hungry for praise, they don't want to go through
the process.
Due process. Because due process takes time. That is also a problem with us Africans, Nigerians. We don't like process. We want to reach the answer without following the process. And that is exactly what explains how we only focus on the Super Eagles.
That's right. OJB, if you look at England, They don't focus not only on national team. They have Premier, good league. Even all the clubs have a junior team.
Yeah,
France, Germany,
all over Europe, even in Slovakia.
So, don't you think all our clubs, NPFL, yeah, don't you think they should have a well-financed, standard junior team who are engaging each other in a good league? Because right now, our best players are not even in the league. Our best talents are in.
Of course.
Chukwueze didn't play any. Osimhen didn't play any. A lot like that.
Yeah, it's a trend now. But they don't play in the NPFL anymore.
So, why can't we build on these templates?
You know, growing up, I remember we used to have a called the Governor's Cup from secondary school. From Governor's Cup, then we have the Noga Games. I don't think all those things are still in place. And even if they are in place now, the glamour, you see, you know, that surrounds it then. What happened to Pepsi Academy? Mikel Obi, I'm sure, is a product of Pepsi Football Academy.
Yeah.
What happened to academies like that? We don't have a structure like that. So what should we do is the answer. Obviously, everybody in Nigeria knows what to do, but we don't have the right people running our football. That's just the truth. It's just as simple as ABC. We don't have the right people running football in Nigeria. They are there to profit from it. They are there just to make money for themselves. So for me, I would say if I happen to be one of the NFF committee or so, let's go back to the roots. Let's ask ourselves, what happened? Atlanta 96, those guys, you could tell, those guys actually, you know, they play the glamour of the home base football. You could see it then. So, and it's, you know, the dividend is what we are even still reaping today. Because the glory of, you know, USA 94, France 96 is still what, you know, the world sometimes still look at us from. They still look at us, you know, with that. Okay, Nigeria, once they win this. So, for me, I think we just have to go back to the drawing board. Yeah, I think this guy is doing the little he could do. The new Minister of Sports, I forgot
something.
Sunday that is doing the little, but he can't do everything. There are some things he's even venturing into now that would be like, a sports minister, I don't need to go that far if we have the right people there.
It's an institution. The institution is not there. I don't believe in focusing on individuals, on the diary, something Abdullah. They come and go. Mm-hmm. We should have institution in place.
Structure
in place. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to ask you now, Homer. Mm-hmm. How can we have good leadership filter through into the NFF? Mm-hmm. And I'm not talking about just NFF president alone.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about solid people around them. I think they are elected to the office, right, through state FA,
through state FA.
How can we
in a system that is flawed out there?
Yes.
Because when you have state FAs who have no say, who are induced with money, they are going to vote for the highest bidder. And that is what happens. And that is how some guys became NFL president. I think that I've said it before, and I'll say it again. The best way to approach or find the right leadership, visionary leadership for Nigerian football is to appoint, not to elect. Because if you elect, you're going to elect always people who have money, but not the right people. Tell me how come Isego Odegbami has never, ever, ever been voted as the NFL ordinary NFL president.
Kojo Williams.
Ordinary NFL. You know why? Because they don't have money to bribe state FA chairman. Or chairman, sorry, pardon me. They don't have the fund to bribe these guys. So when you have a system where you appoint an FA president or FA CEO, not chairman, not president, you are the CEO of Nigerian football, You must develop a blueprint for us. Give us a plan. 4-year plan, 8-year plan. This is what we want to put in place. Develop the game from the grassroots. Set up a league that is functional, commercially viable, and colorful. Things will change because then you're going to have business-minded persons, people with the business acumen, who see football as a business. In South Africa, they did it, and things changed. I went to South Africa in 2006. I met the CEO of South African football, not the president of South African football. Look at what they have, almost a European system. It's vision. But when you have, when you have election, you're always going to elect idiots.
But technically, isn't that why we have the role of technical directors? Before we used to have, I don't know if NFL still, I think right now we don't have technical directors.
Yeah.
But before we have
Technical directors.
Technical directors. Because I think that's their role.
Yeah.
To map out from grassroots.
I think for me now, to add to what Solomon just said, democracy has actually done more harm to our football than good. Look at where we have the likes of the military ruling, when they just appoint. They just appoint, you know. Yeah, you might say the military regime was not good to some extent, but then look at the dividends, 94. I keep saying 94, 96, because that was when we were in top five.
Exactly.
Nigeria was fifth in the world, first in Africa. Because, you know, it was just say appointed, not election, not by elected, you know, some people rallying around with money, you know. So for me, it's just, I'll go with what they said. And if only they will now even appoint the right people, even now, this democracy that we have now, you know how it goes. If you're not part of the party member, they won't even appoint you there. So it's just for me, for them to look at the right people to be appointed and keep them the time. I mean, look at Senegal now. Even look at Algeria now. The team has been together for like 4 years. And those boys together, and look how what they achieved, that they just concluded Nations Cup. Even Senegal, look at the coach. It's a local coach also. And they've been together for years. But one, Nigeria, we're not patient enough. We want Uru to the answer, fire brigade. We want something, okay, 2 years from now. We want to win the Nations Cup. But where is the structure?
Mm-hmm. I think we are in the right direction. Well, we're going to be rounding up. This is just a quick one. I hope we're going to have a good one,
of course,
massive, where we can talk about a lot of things later. I'm gonna quickly ask you, I have like two more questions to go. Omar, with the caliber of players we are right now, this young fantastic talent, from your own view, what's the best way for us to approach 2022 FIFA World Cup? Because for me, the goal should be the world, not AFCON. I always say that we have talent, that our target shouldn't be, of course, we didn't win the last one, but we should be conquering the world. We just play 1-1 with Brazil. So how should we approach Qatar 2022 with this amazing talent everywhere?
Well,
and what's your target? How far do you think we can go?
I mean, it will be too big to ask that they should win the World Cup.
Of course.
Yeah, because it's a young team, they need to grow, they need time to develop. So I think that our focus should actually be the AFCON. Win the AFCON.
Okay.
And once again cement our place as the giant of Africa.
Okay.
Because now we have a new generation, a golden generation, so to say. This is the youngest team we've ever had. Average age.
In fact, in the world right
now, at the last World Cup.
Even right now,
yeah,
we have the youngest national team.
Exactly.
We are number third, right?
Exactly. At the World Cup, we're number one. At the last World Cup. So, we can build on that, but manage our expectations. We shouldn't build castle in the air because it's a young team. They might have an array of stars. They might be shining. But as a team, you can't say that they're going to beat Brazil, beat Germany, beat France You know, they are still going to have their struggles.
Okay.
So I think that we should win the African Nations Cup. That should be our main focus.
Okay.
And then go to the World Cup and do better than we've done before. I'm not saying we should go there and repeat what we've done in the past. We should go to the World Cup and target the quarterfinal stage. At least take it one notch further than what we've done in the past.
Yeah.
And then from there, anything can happen. From the quarterfinal, you can go to the semifinal. But don't be too expectant. Don't have too much expectation that you want to win it because this thing is new.
Okay.
You see, like I said again, I will summarize. We should focus on winning the African Nations Cup and cement our place again as the giant of Africa. And then go to the World Cup with the target of reaching the quarterfinal.
Okay.
And then take it up from there. We can win. Why not?
But
be very modest.
OJB. We have a new sport minister.
Yeah.
If you have to ask.
This is his brother.
Yeah? Okay, I don't know.
But he doesn't know him.
If you have to advise him, not only on football, generally, what's the best advice you would give him? Because he's a sport minister, he's not football.
Not football. No. So far, so good. It's been doing well because I see some of his tweets where he goes to basketball, he goes to cricket, and I saw something about his swimming, I think, a couple of days ago. So, kudos to him. And I like the fact that, you know, he's present on social media. You could, you know, you can interact with him. People say this, people say that. People even throw things at him. And I like the fact that, you know, he replies matured. And before you know, I think if we had this opportunity, like a sport minister that could interact with people, not just the berets, not just those kind of military persons, not something like that, it would be better. I think the sport industry wouldn't be where we are today. So for Daria, is doing awesome, wonderful. So my advice would be you should just still do better than what he's doing now. Go a step further than what he's doing now. There's always a chance to improve on whatever you're doing. And I think it's a better time for him now to rebrand sports in Nigeria.
Yeah.
And it will be a good thing for
Mr. Sport Minister, if you are watching, Omar Akatsugba, OJB, Kulikuli, you know, surround yourself with the best people and make things work. We need foundation, institution in all these things. Finally, guys, little bit away from football, because football is just, this is my belief, football is just one thing, just part of one aspect that lot of things about life, the unrest of our youth. I want you to advise the youth and trying to, because we are here today, we should also be, you know, using our voices to advise, to
encourage
and the unrest and quick money and people want things fast. I just want you to advise the Nigerian youth and we'll round up from there.
Okay, thank you. I'm going to try to be as fast as quick as possible. Everything in life depends on vision. And when you have a vision, it gives you direction. And when you have direction, it makes your life, you know, less complex. My advice to Nigerian youth is to believe in the reward of hard work, to focus not on shortcut, to focus on process, and as well to enjoy whatever process they are going through, because whatever you want to achieve in life requires a process. And if you're not ready for that process, you're not ready for the result. It's like saying that you want to win a lottery without buying a ticket. So my advice would be to stay true to your dreams. Whatever you find your hand to do, do with all diligence. There's nothing better than the other. There's no talent bigger than the other. There's no job better than the other. It depends on your approach. We must be proud of ourselves, and we must take pride in hard work. We must believe once again in the dignity of labor. That is something that is gone from our complete thinking faculty. We must inculcate that habit. Again, our parents were very hardworking. They were able to build a Nigeria that was good until idiots came to destroy everything. So I want to advise young people to stay focused, to believe in hard work, to have a vision, to look up to people who have good reputation. And above all, believe in God.
Thank you very much. What do you think?
Omar said everything. But for me, I would just like to add the fact that look for something that you think you're good at, a passion, something that drives you, and just stick to it. Diligently, hard work, it does pay. It pays. Just do it, you know, focus on it, and I'm sure one day you'll get there.
Thank you very much, guys.
It's always a pleasure.
I hope you're enjoying your stay in Belgium.
Thank you very much as well for hosting us.
Thank you so much.
At a very short notice. You're obliged. I'm very grateful.
Thanks so much, guys.
10 days, I don't dare wait for you, my charger. For you, my charger. You want the phone?
Yes.
No case. I no go.